once again a warm welcome to all my dear students. So today I have come up with a new topic for you, that is electrolysis, right? So today we'll be discussing about the various terms related to this electrolysis and also the concept of electrolysis, and especially we'll be discussing the electrolysis of water. Okay, so as you can see here, the word electrolysis has been derived from two words. Okay, the first is the word electro and the other one is lysis, right? So electro, from the meaning of electro is very clear, that is with the help of electric current or by the supply of electric current, and lysis is the breaking or splitting. So by now you're already aware of the decomposition reactions, right? You have read about the thermal decomposition, and also while studying about the thermal decomposition you came across the word electrolytic decomposition. So that is nothing else but when the decomposition takes place with the help of electric current, that is called as electrolysis. Okay, so it has been derived from two words, electro and lysis. So lysis, that means the splitting up or the decomposition because of the supply of direct electric current, is called as electrolysis, right? So now we can define electrolysis as the decomposition of a chemical compound in its aqueous or molten state by the passage of electric current, right? By the passage of electric current. So this is what is electrolysis. So this means that a particular chemical compound to undergo electrolysis should be in its aqueous state or in its molten state. That means you have to melt the particular chemical compound. Otherwise, if you're taking a solid chemical compound, okay, it may be a strong ionic compound, still it won't undergo electrolysis because the ions will not be free to move, right? So now let's come to electrolyte. So what's an electrolyte? Okay, it is the chemical compound which conducts electric current in its aqueous or molten state. That means an electrolyte itself is a chemical compound which is a good conductor. Which is a good conductor. That means it conducts electric current, but it should be in its aqueous or molten state. And we can also add one more thing here, and gets decomposed itself. That means what? An electrolyte is a chemical compound which is a good conductor of electricity. It conducts electricity through it, but in order to conduct electricity it should be in its aqueous or molten state. And when the electric current is passed through an electrolyte, it itself gets decomposed. Okay, a very common example, students, is let us take an example of very good electrolyte, that is sodium chloride. Okay, so electrolytes are actually of various kinds. We have strong electrolytes, we have weak electrolytes, and we have also some substances which are called as non-electrolytes. They will never conduct electricity, right? So sodium chloride is an example of a very good electrolyte. It's a strong electrolyte because, as you can see here, sodium chloride is made from a strong, it's a salt which is produced from a strong base, sodium hydroxide. Yes, sodium hydroxide and a strong acid which is hydrochloric acid. So you remember the neutralization reaction, I hope. So this way we can get a very strong salt with sodium chloride. So sodium chloride is an electrovalent compound, right? Sodium chloride is an electrovalent compound because this compound is formed because of the formation of electrovalent bond. And as you know, electrovalent bond is a very strong bond. Okay, in the chemical bonding video, I've explained about the electrovalent covalent bond. Once again, you can go through it and understand, okay? So that means what? Already the sodium chloride has Na plus and Cl minus. This bond is because of the formation of oppositely charged ions, the anion and the cation. So here sodium ion is the cation and chloride is the anion. So the there is an electrostatic force of attraction between these two ions, which gives rise to electrovalent bond. And this type of compounds are called as electrovalent compounds. Okay. So they are all these compounds already have ions, but then in the solid form, okay, the ions are not free to move. So solid sodium chloride cannot conduct electricity. So we can say that solid sodium chloride is a bad conductor of electricity. Although it has ions, but in the solid state there is strong electrostatic force of attraction. So that is why it is not a good conductor of electricity in its solid state. But if it is in molten state, that means if you make a solution of sodium chloride with water, it dissociates into its ion Na plus and Cl minus. Or in its molten state also, what happens? Electrostatic bond, the electrostatic force of attraction between the ions weakens and the ions are free to move, right? So before going into the topic further, students, you should understand the meaning of two important words, that is dissociation and ionization. Clear? So now let's talk about these two important terms, that is dissociation and ionization, whose knowledge is very important in order to understand the electrolytes and the process of electrolysis, right? So dissociation is what, students? Suppose if you take the example once again for sodium chloride, we know that it is already in it's already an ionic compound. Electrovalent compounds are also called as ionic compounds. That means ions are already there. Sodium chloride in solid form also contains ions, but the only difference is what? They cannot conduct electricity through them because the ions are not free to move, right? So what happens when this sodium chloride salt is dissolved in water? Water is a covalent compound. Actually, what type of compound is water? Covalent compound. But it has high dielectric constant. It has very high dielectric constant. That means if sodium chloride or any ionic compound is dissolved in water, the water breaks the weakens the bonds between this ionic compound and makes the ions free to move, makes the ions mobile, right? So then what happens? The ion gets separated. That means already the ions were there. Only the ions got separated. Okay. So what is the meaning of dissociation? Ions were present. Ions were already present, but they got separated. Now, what is the meaning of ionization? Ionization is the production of ions. Suppose we take an example of hydrochloric acid. Okay, so hydrochloric acid is what? Basically, it is a covalent compound, or more specifically, a polar covalent compound. Okay, so in the covalent bonding chapter video, I have explained or in detail about these compounds, covalent bonding, electrovalent bonding. Okay, the chemical bonding videos, so you can go through it. Polar covalent compound. So there is what? A partial charge separation in this polar covalent compounds, which is very small, but there are no ions. So here in this case, hydrochloric acid, when hydrochloric acid is dissolved in water, then ions are basically produced. okay, that means ions were not there in the beginning. Okay, ions were not there in the beginning, but on adding water to this acid, it underwent what? Ionization. That means basically produced ions. Clear? So what happens here? You know that H2O is made up of H plus ion and OH minus ion. Clear? So basically what happens in ionization, the ions are produced and then they dissociate. But in dissociation, ions were already there, but they got free after you made an aqueous solution with water. So this is the basic difference between dissociation and ionization. So now when we talk about electrolytes, students, when we talk about electrolytes, okay, so electrolytes are said to be strong when there is complete, or we can say nearly complete dissociation. Clear? I think the idea is clear. That means when those chemical compounds are said to be strong electrolytes, when they are when their aqueous solution or the solution contains mostly ions, no more molecules. Okay, like sodium chloride, sodium hydroxide, potassium chloride, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acids. So when you make a solution with water, in the solution form, they completely dissociate. That means their solution contains mostly what? Ions. But weak electrolytes are what? They don't completely dissociate. Okay, that means their solution contains both ions and molecules, right? Clear? Strong electrolytes are what? When there is complete or nearly complete dissociation, that means their solution contains only ions. In the strong electrolytes, what happens? The solution contains only ions. But weak electrolytes, the solution, this question is also frequently asked in the board examination, right, students? Strong electrolytes are those electrolytes whose solutions contain only ions, but weak electrolytes are those chemical compounds whose solution contains both ions as well as molecules. For example, ammonium hydroxide, acetic acid. So their solution contains both ions as well as molecules. Okay, and there are some substances which are never considered as electrolytes. They are called as non-electrolytes. That means what? They can never conduct electricity. Non-electrolytes, okay, they never conduct electricity. That means they never undergo ionization, okay, like sugar solution, okay, alcohol. So these substances never undergo ionization, okay. Next, it has come to electrodes, another term which is related to this topic, electrodes, okay. So these are nothing but conducting rods or poles through which current enters or leaves the electrolyte. Since electrolysis is because of the passage of electric current, so basically we use some inert kind of metals are also used, okay, but basically graphite and which is an allotrope of carbon, platinum, so all these are basically used as what? Electrodes, generally used as electrodes because they are non-reactive. Clear? Because we don't want the electrolyte to react with the electrodes. Clear? So these are the conducting rods. So there are two types of electrodes, anode and cathode. So anode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, right? Positive terminal of the battery, which is the electrode which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery is called as anode, and the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, negative terminal of the battery, is called as what? कैथोड. ओके, सो कैथोड इज बेसिकली वॉट नेगेटिवली चार्ज इलेक्ट्रोड एंड एनोड इज वॉट पॉजिटिवली चार्ज इलेक्ट्रोड. सो दैट इज वाई वॉट हैपन्स वेन एवर देर इज एन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इन साइड एंड द इन साइड द इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल. अनदर वर्ड इज द इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल. ओके, इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल. वी कैन सी द कंटेनर वेर द प्रोसेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस इज कैरिड आउट. कंटेनर वेर द प्रोसेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस इज कैरिड आउट. सो इनसाइड दिस इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल वी हैव द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो द टू इलेक्ट्रोड्स दैट इज कैथोड एंड द एनोड. राइट, सो वॉट हैपन्स बेसिकली ड्यूरिंग द इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस द एनायंस migrate towards anions. Now cathode, anode is carrying what charge? Positive charge. It's a positive charge electrode, right? So it attracts what? Attracts anions. And cathode is carrying negatively charged, so it attracts cations. Or in other words, we can say that anions migrate towards the anode and cations migrate towards the cathode because oppositely charged ions attract each other, right? So when the particular electrolyte which is present in the electrolytic cell gets decomposed, it gets it dissociates. Okay, then what happens? The positive, like suppose Na plus and Cl minus, let us consider Na plus and Cl minus. So Na plus is positively charged, it is a cation. That is the cation, and chloride is the anion. So during the process, what happens? This cation migrates towards the cathode because cation is carrying positive charge. So it will be attracted towards the cathode, and anion, which is negatively charged, will be attracted towards the positively charged electrode, that is the anode. And both of them basically get discharged at the cathode and the anode respectively. Okay, so that also we'll be discussing. So and one more thing what you need to remember is anode. Now you know students that current enters through anode, because we know that what is the direction of the conventional current. Current flows from the higher potential to the lower potential, that means from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. So the flow of current always takes place from positive to negative. Okay, that is about current. Current always flows from the positive to the negative terminal, but electrons flow from negative to positive terminal. Okay, so that means what? Current enters through the anode and leaves through the cathode. Okay, so we can say that current enters where? To the electrolytic cell, that is where the electrolyte is kept, through the anode, and leaves through the cathode. Clear? Because the direction of current is always from the higher potential to the lower potential. Higher potential is the positive terminal, lower potential is the negative terminal. Clear? I think this idea is clear with you all, and you also know very well by now in physics you have already read that electric current is nothing but the flow of electrons, right? So the negative terminal is always having the excess of electron. Negative terminal is the cathode. So the electrons move from the cathode towards the anode, and current flows from the anode towards the cathode. So now students, I'm going to show you the image of Hofmann's voltmeter where the electrolysis of water is conducted. Okay, so as you can clearly see in the image, this is called as Hofmann's voltmeter. Okay, specially used for the electrolysis of water. So students, now we are going to discuss about the electrolysis of water. Clear? The electrolysis of water. So how does it take place? So for that, a special type of electrolytic cell is used, that is called as Hofmann's voltmeter. I have already shown the image to you, as you can see here. So in the image, this is the place from where we put water plus sulfuric acid. Now why do we use water plus sulfuric acid? Because by nature you know that water is a poor conductor of electricity, right? प्योर वाटर इज अ पुअर कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो इन ऑर्डर टू मेक इट अ गुड कंडक्टर वी यूज अ फ्यू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड व्हिच हेल्प्स टू मेक द वाटर अ गुड कंडक्टर. दैट मीन्स इट विल बी एबल टू कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थ्रू इट व्हेन सम व्हेन अ फ्यू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड इज एडेड. सो व्हाई डोंट वी एड, द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस, व्हाई डोंट वी एड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड और नाइट्रिक एसिड, राइट? द रीजन बिहाइंड इज दैट दिस सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड इज नॉट अ volatile acid, clear? But these acids are volatile acids. The meaning of volatile is what? They get converted into vapor, right? So then our purpose will not be solved. So it, if the acid vaporizes away, then our purpose of making the water a good conductor will not be solved. So that's why a few drops of sulfuric acid is added. So the term used here is what? The electrolysis of basically what? Acidulated or acidified water. Because we cannot conduct the electrolysis of pure water. We can conduct the electrolysis of acidified or acid diluted water, because after adding a few drops of sulfuric acid, water becomes acts as an electrolyte. That means electrolyte is basically what? It is able to conduct electricity through it. It should be able to conduct electricity. So from here, the mixture of water and sulfuric acid is put. Okay. Now to see, students, this is the negative electrode, the cathode. Clear? That means this is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, cathode. This electrode is cathode, and here you can see one more electrode connected to the positive terminal of the battery, that is called as the anode. Clear? Okay. So these are the two electrodes. So here basically you have the mixture of sulfuric acid with water. So now water will act as acid related water will act as what? An electrolyte. Okay. And these electrodes are made of what? Platinum. Okay. Because platinum is not very reactive. Okay. Platinum is not very reactive. So it won't react with the electrolyte, because we don't want the electrolyte to react with the electrodes. Right. So now this is the setup for the electrolysis of water. Now let us see what happens when the electric current is passed. Okay. So when the electric current, after you supply the electric current, the current enters through the anode. Okay. When the current is supplied, what happens? As we know, in the electrolysis, what happens? The electrolyte gets decomposed. So in the electrolyte, you have a mixture of water and sulfuric acid, right? So we know the reaction. What is the reaction? When H2O undergoes decomposition, it decomposes to form H2 plus O2. Yes. Two gases are evolved, that is H2 plus O2. Now we can let us balance the equation also. So 2O, that means here when water undergoes electrolysis, students, we get two volumes of hydrogen and one volume of oxygen. On passing electric current through acidulated water, hydrogen gas is evolved at the cathode and oxygen gas is evolved at the anode. Okay. This is the general idea you are having till now. But then let us understand how this process takes place. Okay. So once the electric current is passed through this electrolyte, we know the meaning of the electrolyte. It conducts electric current and it will itself decompose here. So water. Now let's think about water. So water will decompose to form H plus and OH minus, obviously. But apart from water, students, here you have one more compound. It's not H plus and OH minus alone, but you have one more compound, H2SO4, sulfuric acid, which will also dissociate in, which will also ionize to form H plus and two H plus ions, yes, and sulfate ion. Okay. So now basically in the electrolyte, you have these ions. In the electrolyte, the electrolyte contains water and sulfuric acid. So after the ionization, what happens, what ions are present in this electrolyte? You have the H plus. Okay, so both water and sulfuric acid yield what? H plus ion, which is common ion to both. But then there are two negative ions here, negative radicals you can see here, OH minus and sulfate. Sulfate radical is also present in the electrolyte. Clear? Now one more thing, students. So what basically happens? Now we know that cathode is what? Negatively charged electrode. Cathode is, so let us write down at cathode what happens. What happens at cathode? Now cathode is what type of electrode? It is negatively charged electrode. So obviously it will attract what? H plus ion. Now what are the positive ions present in the electrolyte? H plus, both the acid and the water, they yield what? H plus ion. So that means the H plus ions will migrate towards the cathode. So once the H plus ions migrate towards the cathode, okay, they get discharged. Now let us come to the most important part of this, that means the principle behind this electrolysis. So the method of electrolysis involves two important things, okay. That means the process of electrolysis involves two important things. First is the migration of ions towards their respective electrodes. Second is the discharge. Discharge means what? Becoming neutral. It means what? Losing the charge and becoming neutral. So the purpose of the ions migrating towards the cathode and anode is just to get discharge or to get neutral, because now they are ions, but they want to either lose, they just want to become neutral. That means they want to lose whatever charge is on them. Okay, so now this H plus ion is carrying a positive charge, so it migrates towards the cathode, which is a negatively charged electrode. So basically, how can H plus ion become neutral? By the gain of electron. Yes, so when H plus ions travels towards the cathode, when it comes in contact with the cathode, what happens? The cathode basically gives electron to the H plus ion in order to make it neutral, right? Obviously, there is one excess, that means it is deficient by one electron. So if it gains one electron, it becomes what? H. It becomes what? H. So this is the first stage. First stage of electrolysis is what? Migration of ions. So now we are talking about the reaction at the cathode. Okay, then we will discuss about the anode also. Okay. So at the cathode, what happens? H plus ions from the acid and from the water migrate towards the cathode and they get discharged. That means what? How can H plus become discharged? That by gaining one electron, it gets discharged. But this hydrogen is unstable. So what it does? It combines with another hydrogen atom, okay, because we know that hydrogen atom is unstable. So it combines with another hydrogen atom and forms what? H2. So we can say that at the cathode, what is liberated at the towards the cathode? Hydrogen gas is liberated. And where this gas will be collected? The gas will be collected here. Okay, so we have a mixture of what? We have a mixture of acid and water over here. So as the gas starts collecting, this area, that means what? We have read about the downward displacement of water, so all these things you have read, yes or no? So as the gas starts collecting, this space starts looking empty. This is not empty, but there is what? Hydrogen gas over here. Clear? So this is the reaction at the cathode. Now let's talk about the reaction at the anode. So what happens at the anode now? Anode is positively charged electrode, so it will attract the negative charge ions or radicals, whatever present in the electrolyte. So you have here OH minus and sulfate. Now the question arises, which ion will migrate towards the anode? Which negatively charged ion or the radical, here in this case you have radicals, will migrate towards the anode, right? So for that, you have a small series I'm going to give you, that is called as a preferential discharge series, where you have first sulfate, chloride, iodine, hydroxide. Okay, so this is the series: sulfate, nitrate, chloride, bromide, iodide and hydroxide or hydroxyl. So here what happens? The lower one, that means the lower one gets discharged first. The lower one gets discharged, okay, as compared to the the radicals which are present above, the radicals of the ions which are present above. That means the preferential discharge relief for hydroxide. So as you can see here, you have in the electrolyte of this electrolysis of water, you have the hydroxide ion and the sulfate radical. Both are radicals, okay? So which will preferentially discharge? Obviously the one at the lower position. So which is at the lower position? Sulfate is here and hydroxyl or hydroxide ion is here. So obviously hydroxide radical will discharge preferentially at the anode, okay? So what happens here? So OH minus ion, okay? So it is it wants to get discharged. So now it migrates towards the anode. So obviously it has to lose electron. So if it loses electron, it becomes what? OH. Obviously it's having excess of one negative charge. So by losing that electron, OH becomes discharge or it becomes neutral. See students, what is the purpose of this electrolysis? First is the migration of ions. The oppositely charged ions migrate towards the respective oppositely charged electrodes. And what is the purpose of this migration? In order to get discharge. Discharge is what? The absence of charge. They want to get rid of their charge, right? So OH minus, obviously by losing electron we get discharge. That is OH, it becomes OH. Now this is unstable. So this OH combines with another OH. Now why did I write like this? Because just to show you that this will combine to form what? Water. Clear? So what happens? This OH, whatever is formed here, is unstable. So this OH combines with another OH to form what? Water. And this is called as what? Nascent oxygen. This is called as nascent oxygen. And this nascent oxygen is also unstable. So this nascent oxygen then combines with another nascent oxygen to produce what? Oxygen gas. So we can say that oxygen gas is liberated at the anode. So this hydrogen gas here, in this case, hydrogen gas will be evolved at the cathode and oxygen gas will be evolved at the anode. And you know that if you see the main reaction, students, two volumes of hydrogen gas and one volume of oxygen gas. So that means what? More amount of hydrogen gas, two volumes of hydrogen gas. Suppose this is hydrogen gas collected over here, then oxygen gas will be half of it, right? Clear? So here oxygen gas will be collected. Suppose this is oxygen gas, clear? So now that means double the volume of hydrogen gas as compared to oxygen gas will be collected at the cathode. And one more important thing, students, that is left out is the reaction that takes place at the cathode and the anode. Now if you see at cathode, what happens at the cathode? You can see the H plus ion gains electrons. And you know what is gain of electron? Gain of electrons is nothing but the reduction. So basically we can say that at cathode reduction takes place, yes, and at anode you can see there is loss of electrons, so that is oxidation. Clear? So what basically happens here? At cathode there is reduction. Why there is reduction? Because at the cathode there is gain of electrons. And at anode, why there is oxidation? Because here there is loss of electrons. So we can say that reduction takes place at cathode and oxidation takes place at anode. So I hope, students, with this your idea about the electrolysis must be quite clear. So go through the video carefully, try to understand each and every term which is related to this topic, and to the next class, study well. Take care.